Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. Today is our monthly Q&A, so my apologies in advance to everyone whose names I will butcher throughout this video. Before we get to the questions, let's get high on tea. This week's tea is 雪山云绿, a tea with a beautiful name as well as good flavor.雪山云绿 consists of four characters. 雪 means snow, 山 means mountain, 云 means cloud, and 绿 means green. Put together, it means snow mountain in the white cloud and green cover. As mentioned in prior videos, there are different ways to categorize Chinese tea. Processing method.Geographic regions, seasons to collect the tea leaf, the shapes of a tea leaf, and so on. 雪山云绿 is a green tea according to its processing method. It is also a spring tea because it is harvested in the springtime, and most importantly, it is the needle-shaped tea, one categorized by leaf shape.Very often, when people think about dried tea leaves, they don't pay enough attention to the varieties in leaf shapes. Now, let me show you some typical and popular tea leaf shapes. Xue Shan Yun Lu tea originates from Tonglu, Zhejiang Province.Historically, this tea has been the birthplace of many famous green teas with about 1,000 years worth of history. Many green teas, especially 雪山云绿, are naturally grown in that region. Especially in the last few decades, traditional processing methods combined with new technology have drastically improvedtea quality. 雪山云绿 has a very fresh flavor due to its balanced tea polyphenols and L-theanine content. While the processing method for 雪山云绿 is simple like that of other popular green teas, it is critical to process it in the right way due to the necessity to pick tea leaves earlier otherwise.Causing bitter taste, an indicator of poor quality 雪山云绿. To brew 雪山云绿, people usually prefer to use water at 85 degrees Celsius for 30 seconds. However, I prefer a much higher temperature for good quality tea. For example, for this one, I usually use water at 95 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds. I found this produces a much better flavor. So, brewing with water at 90 to 95 degrees Celsius for 15 seconds is ideal for good quality tea. This is the tea leaf after brewing.This is the tea decoction. Very bright color with a fresh and delicious flavor due to its chemical components. 雪山云绿 is very healthy and tastes good. It is not produced on a large scale, which makes it expensive. People drink 雪山云绿 for both health and flavor.To let me know your experiences with 雪山云绿 in the comments. Now, let's get on with today's Q&A. Questions answered today include. First, Guillermo Gutierrez, Salvation in Taoism. Second, Chachaman 289, Breathing Exercise for Lungs. Third, from Nominal. Daoyin exercises. Fourth, from GM Chess and TaiQiGong Academy, Chen Style Routines. Fifth, from FREDtalk, Mao You, Qiao Mai, Da Bao and Bao Mai. And sixth, from Michael Peace, Best Bagua Style. Seventh, Kenli Loans, Wuji State. Eighth, from Tieu Kai I, Mouth Breathing versus Nose Breathing. Ninth, from Anonymous, First, Mandarin for Classical Text. Tenth, Anonymous, Two-Person Set. 11th, Anonymous, Baton Training. 12th, Anonymous, Taoist Alchemy and Placebo Effect. So, let's get started. Guillermo Gutierrez asks if there is anything like salvation or redemption in both religious and philosophical Taoism. Thank you. To my knowledge, religious Taoism does have the concept and the practice of salvation and redemption, as with many other religions. However, there's no such concept in philosophical Taoism. I only practice philosophical Taoism, like most other Taoist practitioners nowadays in China. Hope that answers your question, Guillermo. Let's move on to the next one. Chachaman 289 asks about breathing exercises to improve lung function in asthmatics. Thank you, Chachaman 289. Breathing exercises, besides other exercises and therapies, can improve lung function in certain ways. Any physical exercises, if performed well, will have a positive impact on our overall well-being. My grandfather told me that in the old days, many people practiced different breathing exercises to alleviate chronic conditions, including asthma. However, that is not medical advice and should not be treated as such. I recommend you consult your doctor before practicing anything. Hope that helps. Chachaman 289. Let's move on to the next one. Nominal asks about the role of Daoyin exercises regarding internal cells and Neigong in general. Thank you, Nominal. This is a very interesting question. Broadly speaking, Daoyin is another popular name for Qigong exercises. So, Qigong and Daoyin are interchangeable. Daoyin is practiced for health, not for martial skills. Neigong in martial arts has the specific meaning compared to a general term such as Daoyin. I recommend checking out my video titled Internal Style Concept 22, 内功外用, in which I have explained the concept and the practice of internal practice through different solutions in detail, along with clarification of some common misperceptions. Link is in the description. Nominal, hope that answers the question. Let's move on to the next one. GM Chess and TaiQiGong Academy asks whether one should discontinue the first Chen style routine while learning the second Chen style routine. Thank you for this question. Short answer, no. You do not have to stop or discontinue practice of the first routine while learning the second one. The second routine is built upon the first routine. Furthermore, many movements are the same in both routines with different ways to release power. So, I do not recommend discontinuing the practice of the first routine while practicing the second routine. I hope that answers your question. Let's move on to the next one. FREDtalk asks about Mao You channel and Qiao Mai, Da Bao and Bao Mai. Thank you, Fred. I'm impressed to see that you, you know those terms since they are used in acupuncture practice. Mao You channel is a way to refine our energy and it goes beyond a specific meridian or channel. The other terms you used, Qiao Mai and Bao Mai, are specific meridians and there's no direct relationship between them and Mao You circulation. Xiu Dao practice goes beyond meridians and TCM. Of course, many people try to use the TCM concept to explain or comprehend Xiu Dao practice. Actually, that approach only ends up complicating a simple thing. It's effectively hindering the practice of Xiu Dao. TCM uses Taoist term to explain its practice, not the other way around. Fred, I hope that answers your question. Let's move on to the next one. Michael Peace asks, what style of Bagua Zhang is the best to learn and why? Thank you for this question, Michael. I have to say that all of the styles of Bagua are the best to learn if you can find a qualified teacher and have enough energy to devote to it. Having said that, I would like to provide a quick comparison between two styles of Bagua that I have practiced, Cheng style Bagua and Xing Yi Bagua Palm or Zhang Zhaodong style of Bagua. Between these two styles, Cheng style is definitely a better choice because it is a pure Bagua. Unlike Zhang Zhaodong's Xing Yi Bagua Palm, which is the Xing Yi influenced Bagua. Also, to practice Zhang Zhaodong style Bagua, you need to have some prior Xing Yi training background, which makes learning this style a lot more challenging. So, I recommend you choose a Bagua style for which you can find a qualified teacher and then focus on it. Then move on to other Bagua styles if you have the opportunity. Michael, I hope that answers the question. Let's move on to the next one. Kenli Lin's Tai Chi Chuan Qigong asked a question about Wu Ji state, which I would like to read out first. Quote, is this right to say that we are in a Wu Ji state only at the very early beginning of the routine, at the moment where we are in a double weight with yin and yang undifferentiated, and as the movement starts and until the end, we are in Tai Chi or Liang Yi state, as normally we will never be with a 50-50 weight during the movements or at the end of the movements when we sink down, and at the end of the routine, we return to Wu Ji state, end quote. Thank you, Kenli. Well, Wu Ji state is a state, so as long as you can manage your practice in that state, that will be Wu Ji state. Wu Ji state is the combination of mental and physical aspects. So, it should be managed both mentally and physically. Wu Ji practice is meant to dynamically handle the Wu Ji state to be able to manage energy at an advanced level. So, you should not limit the Wu Ji state to a 50-50 stance. An advanced practice should be handled dynamically, not mechanically. I hope that answers your question, Kenli. Let's move on to the next one. Tieu Kai asks, what type of breathing is better for health, longevity, and burning fat? Mouth breathing or nose breathing? Well, according to Taoism practice, normally, breathing through the nose is more recommended in most practices than through the mouth. For example, in Xiu Dao practice, breathing through the nose is important since it can really balance our internal energy. Of course, if someone cannot breathe through the nose due to reasons such as a medical condition, then breathing through the mouth is accepted as well. Also, it is worth noting that in the older days, there was no such concept of a burning fat through breathing. So, I cannot answer that part for you. I hope that helps. Tin Kai Ai. Now, let's look at the final set of questions for today. Anonymous asked 4 questions that I will answer one by one. First, he asked about the necessity to study Mandarin in order to read classical martial art texts. In my opinion, learning Mandarin is not necessary. It is more important to find a good source of information than to learn a new language. Also, classical texts contain a lot of jargon that is not easy to understand without a good explanation. Furthermore, even if you know the Chinese language, a simple term may often have multiple different meanings. So, it's important to understand the term as the original author intended it and not understand it as per your own convenience. So understanding classical text goes beyond merely learning a language. His second question, quote, can 2-person sight practiced correctly suffice for self-defense situations in lieu of sparring? End quote. Short answer, no. 2-person sight cannot replace free sparring. 2-person sights only provide limited benefits. An important point worth noting is that in self-defense and combat practice, you need to develop your subconscious mind to automatically respond to any incoming attack. That's why 2-person sight practice cannot replace free sparring practice. His third question, quote, should one hit oneself with a baton, either wooden or metal, to improve one's fighting potential, end quote. Short answer, no. Hitting oneself with a baton can only increase your endurance of physical pain. It does not have much to do with one's fighting potential. In a combat situation, many skills are necessary, including but not limited to physical strength, experience, speed, and timing. His final question is, quote, Daoist alchemy, do these practices provide anything beyond a placebo effect, end quote. First, let's clarify what the placebo effect is. A placebo effect refers to a treatment that appears real but is designed to have no therapeutic benefit. A placebo can be a sugar pill, water or saline water injection, or even a fake surgical procedure. So, first of all, Daoist alchemy is not a treatment. It is a personal experience. If someone tries to convince you that Daoist alchemy can provide a magical result and you believe in it, then it may be a case of a placebo effect. However, Daoist alchemy or Xiu Dao is an internal energy practice which integrates the mind, lifestyle, physical practice, diet, and many other aspects to achieve a state of well-being. So, this practice has nothing to do with the placebo effect. I hope that answers all your questions, Anonymous. That brings us to the end of this month's Q&A. Thank you all for your questions and hope you find my answers informative. As always, please do not hesitate to ask follow-up questions or ask new questions altogether. Thank you for watching, see you next time, and enjoy your practice.